to my channel and welcome to today's video. So the chances are at some point in your time of owning rats, you are going to have to give them medication. Rats are very prone to illnesses, unfortunately so. Whether this is just a respiratory infection where they need some antibiotics, or something more serious like a surgery where they need painkillers and anti-inflammatories afterwards, chances are at some point you are going to have to give your rats medication.
So this can be quite tricky. Some medications will taste quite nice, and the rats will immediately take to it and quite enjoy eating the medication. But being so intelligent, chances are quickly they will catch on and know what you're trying to do, and within a few doses, they are going to change their mind and start rejecting the medication. And also some medications can taste and smell really, really nasty, and they're just going to turn their noses up to it straight away. So as none of my rats right now are currently taking medication, I am just demonstrating using water, and unfortunately it's not going to be this easy most of the time to get a rat to take medication straight out of the syringe like this. So in this case, whether you just have a very stubborn rat or the medication tastes and smells really disgusting, you are going to have to try to disguise the taste. So in terms of administering the medication, I really don't recommend pinning your rat down and forcing the meds into their mouth. Not only is this going to be very stressful for them, but most of the time this just doesn't work. They're going to be struggling, trying to get away from you, scratching you, spitting the medication out, and this way you are going to waste a lot of the medication, and you don't want to do this because meds are expensive and you only get a certain amount when you get given them by the vets. But most importantly, if your rat is very ill, they are going to be very stressed and you don't want to do anything to further stress them and make their symptoms worse. So obviously if you try every other option first and you're still struggling to get them to take the medication, especially if this is a life-saving medication that they actually really need, then you may just have to get someone to hold them for you and help you out. But this does pose the risk of the rats aspirating on the medication, which is where it goes down the trachea instead of the esophagus and enters the rat's lungs, and any fluid on the lungs can cause them to develop pneumonia, and this can be fatal. So trying to force medication into your rats can actually be really dangerous, so I really don't recommend trying this and using this as your first option. I do recommend if you try all of the other things I am going to suggest and you still can't get your rats to take the meds, I do recommend taking them back to the vets and see if they can help you out with it at all before trying to force your rats, especially if you don't know what you're doing. You can just end up making things a lot worse. So the examples I'm going to show you today is going to be with medication in liquid form. Sometimes if you go to the vets, they can prescribe you tablets. Now this is even harder to get into rats because you have to crush the tablets down and then make them into a liquid or mix them into things to get the rats to actually take those tablets. So hopefully if you are going to the vets and getting some medication, it's in liquid form, because that is so much easier than trying to get a tablet in a rat.
So I thought I'd share with you today some of the things that I use to trick my rats to take their medication, just in case you currently have a sick rat and you're struggling, or you just want to prepare for the future when you do have to give rats medication. So the first thing I recommend you have on hand in your rat supplies is something called malt paste. Now this is considered rat crack in the rat community because they just can't resist this, they go crazy for it. And it's also a really good thing to mix their medication in just because it is so high value to them. So I don't currently have any malt paste with me. I did run out and I've not bought any more because it is quite pricey, so I probably will get some more at some point. But I do recommend you have this on hand just in case you find yourself with a rat that needs medication and you need something really good to mix it with. So some other liquidy foods that are really good for mixing in with medication are human food. Something I use is ketchup. Now I do find they get a bit bored of this after a few doses, but I have mixed medication in with ketchup in the past. That's a really good thing to mix it in with. Also, baby food is a really good option. So I do recommend when going out to look for baby foods, there is so many different options, it can be quite overwhelming, but I do recommend going for one that is meat-based. Rats do really seem to enjoy ones that have meat in. With these, I would say please check the ingredients on the back and make sure they don't have any onions in. Rats can't have onions, and I have found that most baby foods that have meat in do also have onions in, so please check the ingredients on the back before buying one for your rats. You could also try sweet baby foods. Again, you just want to check the ingredients on the back, and especially if you have male rats, make sure these don't have any citrus in. Another thing I've found to be really good for mixing in with their medication is dog peanut butters. I would say avoid human ones, these can have more of a sticky consistency, and with rats they do have the potential to choke on these, so no human peanut butter, but I have found that certain brands of dog ones do have a more watery consistency, and these are also really good for mixing in with their meds. So if you've tried all of the liquid options and that doesn't seem to work, you can also soak the medication into solid foods. I would say avoid things like bread. Bread again has this sticky consistency and it does have the potential for them to choke on this, so if I'm desperate, something I use is prawn cracker. I'll take a tiny piece of prawn cracker and soak the medication into this, and then they just eat it and have no idea that it does actually have medication in it. So at the end of the day, if your rats are on medication, this is for a health reason, so I wouldn't worry too much about what you're trying to put the meds in is healthy or not. I would usually say try to give your rats as healthy as a diet as possible, but if you're desperate and you are trying to mix the medication with something, don't worry too much if you found something that does work and it's not necessarily the healthiest thing for them. As long as you're getting those meds into them, that is the main thing. Another thing is, if your rats are on a course of medication for a week or 2 weeks, I definitely recommend mixing up what you are mixing the medication in with. They can get very bored of just giving the same option every single day, so I do recommend giving them a variety of different things mixed in with their meds, just so they don't catch on to what you're trying to give them. So maybe one day give them it in baby food, the next day give it to them in dog peanut butter, something like that. Just keep mixing it up to make sure they don't catch on.
So in terms of where to offer them the food, I would say try them in the cage first. This is where they're going to feel the most safe and comfortable. If you take them out of the cage, they might feel that something is up. So I would say try them in the cage first. I tend to mix all of mine onto a spoon, so I mix the food I'm trying to hide the medication in with the medication on a spoon, and then I just poke it into their hammock if they're asleep. Usually they get very excited and just grab it straight away. Obviously you do want to make sure that none of the other rats can access this food and they don't try to eat it too, because you are trying to give medication to one specific rat. You don't want the other rats obviously ingesting and eating that medication too. So your other rats, especially if you have quite a few, will probably try to swarm you to get to this food source, so do just be careful they don't get any. You may have to take your rat out of the cage just to try to give it its medication, but this can also be a really good thing if your other rats are trying to get the food. The rat you're actually trying to give the meds to may see this as a higher value treat, and it also may hurry them up in eating it and distract them away from the fact that this food does kind of taste a bit weird, but the other rats are also trying to eat it, so I'm going to eat it too. So alternatively, if you have a weaker, sicker rat, or they're just not overly interested in the medication initially, you may have to take them out and pop them into a carrier and just give them the medication and the food mixed into a small bowl, and then just leave them to eat it on their own terms. So hopefully some of these tips were helpful to you if you have a rat that needs medication, or just preparing you for the future. These tips have worked for me, but they might not necessarily work for you. Sometimes you may just have a very stubborn rat that no matter what you try, it's not going to take these meds. It will either smell them or taste them in the mixture you've made, so sometimes some rats will need alternative measures to get them to take their medication. So I'm not going to be showing you in this video how to give your rats medication by force. Hopefully some of these tips helped, but sometimes you will just have a very stubborn rat that doesn't want to take medication no matter what, and in this case I do really recommend going back to your vet. So obviously it can be quite serious if you can't get your medication into your rats, because they are on it for a reason, so I do recommend if you are having trouble, please go back to your vet and discuss other options. Sometimes some medications can be given in an injection form if you're unable to get the medication into them another way, so if you are having any troubles and your rat's health is declining, please go back and see your vet. But I still hope this video was helpful to you. Please make sure you are subscribed to see any more animal content from me, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!